हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू 20 फिंगर्स टू ब्रेन। दिस इज़ पार्ट टू ऑफ ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग कार्ट प्रोजेक्ट। वी हैव ओपन द ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग कार्ट प्रोजेक्ट इन आवर विजुअल स्टूडियो। हेयर वी हैव टू मॉड्यूल्स, वन इज़ एडमिन मॉड्यूल, अनदर वन इज़ यूज़र मॉड्यूल। फ्रॉम द एडमिन पार्ट वी आर एडिंग द प्रोजेक्ट्स, एडिंग द न्यू प्रोडक्ट्स, एडिंग द क्रिएटिंग अ न्यू कैटेगरी। सो इन दिस एप्लीकेशन वी हैव क्रिएटेड अ फोल्डर एंड we have named this folder as admin. To create a folder we have to right click on this project, add new folder and name it as admin. Inside this folder we have added a new page, login.aspx. this page is used to authenticate the administrator of this web application. To add this page what we have done is right click on the admin folder, add new item, select web and web form and name it as login.aspx. click on add, this page will get added. So when we run this page it will look like this. We have a tabular structure, we have login ID, password and a button which will fire the login event. So when we add this page we will only have this body structure. In this body structure we have the form ID equal to form1, run at equal to server. Inside this forms we have added a div and inside the div we have a table. To bring this tabular structure, to create this much gap, we have added margin equal to 200 pixel. Then we have a table the width of the table is 450 pixel and we have applied a style like border 1 pixel, ridge and some color. We have one table row, second table row, third table row, fourth table row and five table rows. In the first table row we have added a label and applied some font name, font color and font weight, and inside the text we have written shopping cart hyphen admin panel, and we have applied the column span equal to 2 because in the second TR we are having two table data. First table data is for login ID and the second is for the text which the user is going to enter in the login ID text box. The second goes for password and the password text box. And we have aligned everything to center, and the width we have applied 50% and 50% so that the things look better. Here we have the button, login button, and we have added a HR tag in the last TR and we have also added a HR tag in the first TD. So when we click on the button, the login button should fire. We have a LBL alert and we have changed the color to red. So this is what it look like. We have the first TD, we have a tabular structure TD followed by HR tag, then we have the second TR with 2 TD, third TR with 2 TD, fourth TR with 2 TD. This one is empty and this side we have a login button and then followed by HR, and then we have the LBL alert to show any warnings. This, when we click on this button, the btn login underscore click event is generated. As we have discussed in the first part of this video series, we have added two keys in the web config file. One is admin login ID and another is admin password. So we are reading those admin login ID and admin password from the web config file using web config manager dot app settings. To use this web configuration manager we have to add this namespace using system dot web dot configuration, and then using simple if else we are checking whether the what user have entered is correct or not. Now the text login.text equal to login ID and the password.text is equal to the password, then we are redirecting the user towards the add new product dot page. And before redirecting the user, we are creating a session so that user can be authenticated. We are creating a session shopping heart admin, and we are, and the text what we have entered in that is shopping heart admin. If the username and password is incorrect, we are adding a text in the LBL alert label like incorrect login ID password. So let's put a breakpoint over here and set a startup page. Okay, so we have this design view. Now, as per the web config, the login ID is admin and the password is 123. So let's first enter something incorrect. Now when I click on this, I read the login ID and password from the web config file, and I'm getting it as admin and 123. So when I compare this, the text which is entered by user is Kaka and the password is also Kaka. So they are not matching. So the user is getting redirected to the else part, and we are showing the warning like incorrect login ID password. So this time we are going to enter the correct login ID and password. Let's see what happened. Now we are entering in this, and the session, we have created a session. Now as you can see, the value of the session is shopping heart admin, and this session we are going to use in other pages. Now from here we are going to redirect to admin add new products.aspx. So press F5. So as you can see, we are inside the admin panel. So this was how we have created a login page for our admin module. The next part, like adding a new product and add edit category, will continue in part 3 of this video series. Thanks for watching.